so surface areas and volumes. Now this is exercise 13.1. so in question 1, so question 1, we have two cubes each of volume 64 centimeter cube are joined end to end. Find the surface area of the resulting cuboid. So volume is given, so directly we can go to the formula. What is the volume of one cube? So we can say volume of cube, first we are just writing down the information, of one cube is equal to 64 centimeter cube. So now we know that volume of cube is equal to, what's the formula for that? A cube, right? So volume is, A cube is equal to 64 centimeter cube. So A is equal to cube root of 64. So cube root of 64 will give me 4 centimeter, right? So one of the side of that cube is equal to 4 centimeters. So now we say they are joined end to end. So suppose this is one cube and this is another cube. So another cube is like this. So it has been joined end to end. Okay. This goes like this. So these are joined. So each edge is 4, right? So 4 centimeter, 4 centimeter. So the length, now new form will be the cuboid, resulting cuboid. So resulting cuboid will have 8 centimeter length, but my height will remain as 4 centimeter and my width is also 4 centimeter. The resulting cuboid has length is equal to 8 centimeter and breadth will be 4 centimeter only and height will also be 4 centimeters. Correct? So these are the, so now I have to find the surface area of the resulting coin. I have to find the surface area. Okay, so now surface area formula for cuboid will be equal to 2 into LB plus BH plus LH, right? So I can substitute my thing. So 2 into 8 into 4 plus 4 into 4 plus 8 into 4, right? So this will be equal to 2 into 32 plus 4, 4 is 16 plus 32. So now this has come out to be 2 into how much? 6 and 4, 10, 1 carry. So 6 and 2, 80. So this is equal to 160 centimeter square, right? So this will be my answer for this. Point 1, we are on the question number 2. So now they are saying a vessel is in the form of a hollow hemisphere mounted by a hollow cylinder. The diameter of the hemisphere is 14 centimeter and the total height of the vessel is 13 centimeter. Find the inner surface area of the vessel. So let's always try to make it a figure, whatever information is given. So that will make your solution easy and understandable. So it is in the form of a hollow hemisphere. So okay, hollow hemisphere here, and then I have mounted by a hollow cylinder. So this has been mounted by a hollow cylinder. So the diameter of the hemisphere is 14. So diameter is 14. So my radius will be equal to 7 centimeter, and same for the hemisphere. So that will be fine. And the total height is 13. So total height of this is 13 centimeter, right? So 13 centimeter means this is a sphere. So radius will be same for them. This is also the radius. So this is also 7 centimeter. So remaining will be equal to, this much will be 13 minus 7. So this will be equal to 6 centimeter. So we have got all our dimensions and our figure clear. Now I have to find the surface area of the vessel. So surface area means I have to find the surface area of the vessel. Surface area of the vessel. So vessel means I have to find the curved surface area of cylinder, right, plus curved surface area of hemisphere. So that will give me the total surface area, right? So surface area of hemisphere and surface area of cylinder. So then surface area of cylinder formula is 2 pi r h, and for curved surface area of hemisphere will be equal to 2 pi r square, correct? So only curved surface area we are doing. So now I can take 2 pi common, because that is same. Even I can take even pi common, and r is also same for both of them, so pi r common. So what will be left? H plus r. So I can say 2 into pi is 22/7. If it is not mentioned, we usually take 22/7. Radius is also equal to 7, and height of the this cylinder is equal to 6, and radius of cylinder is 7. Okay, so this I have. So now let's calculate. 7 will go cancelled, and then I have 44 into 13, right? So 13 fours are 52, and 57, so 572 centimeter square. That will be my answer for this question, right? Number 3. So question number 3, it says a toy is in the form of a cone of radius 3.5 mounted on a hemisphere of same radius. The total height of the toy is 15.5, and find the total surface area of the toy. Okay, so surface area is usually what we see, right? So individually, if we have to see, we just have to see the draw the diagram first. So the toy is in the form of a cone. Okay, so this is my cone. The diagram should be neat and clean. Of radius 3.5, so this radius is 3.5 centimeter mounted on the hemisphere. So let's this be my hemisphere of the same radius. So same radius, definitely. The total height of the toy is 15.5 centimeter. Okay, and total surface area you have to find out. So total surface area you have to find out. Okay, so now this is 3.5, so this will also be 3.5, right? So this will be how much? 15.5 minus 3.5, so this will become 12 centimeters. So height of the cone becomes 12 centimeter. Okay, so now total surface area of this toy will be total surface area of toy will be equal to curved surface area of cone plus curved surface area of hemisphere, right? Okay, so now let's write down the formula for these things. So surface area of surface area of the cone will be equal to how much? So for that, I think we need to find out pi r l, right? Pi r l plus hemisphere will be 2 pi r square. So for this, first I have to find the l, right? So l is my slant height of the cone. So l square will be equal to h square plus r square. So now l square, h is equal to how much? 12 square plus 3.5 whole square, right? Okay, so how much is this now? This is equal to 144 plus 35 into 35 is 5, and 12.25. Okay, so this comes out to be 156.25. So L will be equal to how much? L will be equal to 12.5, right? 12.5. So when you find the square root, so if you want to learn how to find out the square root, should we do it now? Okay, so let's learn how to find out. So little bit of this thing. So 156.25. So we know division method, right? So division method, I have to make pairs. Okay, so this will come out to be 1, 1's a 1 first, and then 56 here, this becomes 2. So how many times now? 2 times, because 44, right? In pairs I have to take down, right? Okay, so this becomes 44, this becomes 2, 2, and I have to take down these 2 in pairs again. So now this becomes 24, and I have to find my units digit. So 5, right? 5. 5 5s are 25, 5 4s are 20 to carry, so 5 2s are 10, 11, 12. So that is the way of finding the square root. So I got 12.5. So that is my L. Okay, so now in this formula, pi is common and r is also common. I can take pi common and r common. So pi is common, then r is common, so what is left now? L plus 2r. Okay, pi is 22 by 7, then radius is 3.5, we know from this figure, and length is equal to L, we found out as 12.5 plus 2 into radius is 3.5. okay, so this is 0.5 here, and 0.5 into 2 is 11. 11 into, now this comes out to be 12.5 plus 7, right? So 12.5 plus 7, so 11 into 19.5. okay, so now let's multiply. This is my rough work. You can always make a column. So 195 and 195, if I multiply 11 by 95, so 5 and 9 and 5, 14, 1 carry, 11 to 2145, right? So one decimal point, so I can write down 214.5, and unit everything is given in centimeter, so centimeter square. So that's my answer. So I can say that what had they asked? The total surface area of the toy, right? So the total surface area of the toy is equal to 214.5 centimeter square, right? Okay.